Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to The Godfather, The Mob Wars. It is part four, and I did a little bit of The Mob Wars off screen, and I had to get myself a Tommy gun. Yeah, one of the guys dropped it. So, with that said, let's go on ahead and play some more of the story mode, because we did some Mob Wars in the last part, and the whole part was dedicated to the Mob Wars. Now, we can go on ahead and continue on with the story with The Don is Dead.
Hey, mister. Monk Malone, you know him? I'm supposed to meet him here.
Hey, relax. He went outside for a few. He'll be back. Take a seat.
Keep the car running. It's a work day. Keep your mind on the job.
Hey, Francis!
Marty!
Over here. Hey, sis. How you doing? How's the old man?
Good. Most days. He's tired.
Aspetta, Fred. I'm gonna buy some fruit.
Okay, Pop.
Not a chance.
What's up?
Monk! Thank God. Luca's dead.
Luca?
Thank you very much. You're very kind. Merry Christmas.
I'm calling the ambulance, Monk.
No.
You'll be all right.
Frankie, my sister, she's out there.
Well, I have to say, without having any sort of vehicles, The Don is Dead is actually pretty easy, to be honest with you. Anyway, time to kill off some made men. That is, if past me doesn't accidentally hit the save state button on the damn emulator. Anyway, we have to take care of Enrico Maserati, a guy who used to own a car shop until I killed him. And then Enzo Zoff, he was half Russian, but then I killed him. And then Ernesto Bonetti, I had to kill him too, because, well, he has a thing of bad touching girls. And he joined the Tattaglia because, well, the Tattaglia are scum. Anyway, we've got one more person to deal with. I thought this would actually help Frankie, but... oh, this guy. Federico Dello. He was called the delivery man. And the reason why, because he used to deliver pizzas until he became a soldado for the Tattaglia. And now he's dead. Hand tossed.
You okay?
Yeah, I think so. I've met worse than him.
You're Frankie, right? Monk's sister.
Yeah, why?
He's been shot.
Oh, God. What happened?
It was a hit. I think the Don is dead.
Hey, you gotta help me get my pop to the hospital. Get in. We'll follow the ambulance.
No car chase because there's no automobiles, so that scene's been skipped completely. Time to save the Don. First, we're gonna have to kill Fabio Donato because he was a movie star. We gotta kill Franco Lazzaro too. They call him the Lacerator because he loves to slit people's wrists. Unfortunately, he's getting lacerated. Next up, we're gonna have to hide and get some money, but first, we gotta kill the guy right over there. Giancarlo Lucci. They called him Carl for short because his name was too hard to pronounce. And Giovanni Luchetto. Well, they call him Loose Lips Luchetto because, well, punch him in the lips, and as you can see, he loves to talk. So he basically revealed to us that the Turk, Solazzo, is responsible for all this. Oh, and by the way, the Don's health will still go down if you don't make it to the ambulance.
We need some help here. Let's get some help over here.
Hey, Fray. What the hell happened?
Sonny, I...
Pop! God damn it!
Back away.
What's this guy watching a movie? Get him out of here! Fredo, get your ass over here.
Hey, kid. Don't mind Sonny. It's just that seeing his pop like that. So what happened out there?
We got trapped on the bridge. Guy there says something about Solazzo and your consigliere.
Consigliere? Tom, what else did he say, kid? This is important. What else?
He said they were in an old diner in Brooklyn.
Christ. I hope Tom is okay. He's not the fighting type. We'll take it from here, kid.
Head on over to the compound.
Let me speak plainly. The Corleone family has need of men like you. Because as we speak, our enemies encircle us, waiting to prey on any sign of weakness.
What can I do for the family?
We would like to offer you a role as an unofficial enforcer for the family. See that we maintain control on the streets, help us to regain our true balance. In time, you will become a trusted associate to our family, and then, God willing, you will become one of our made men.
Well, this isn't necessarily a promotion, to say the least, because Enforcer actually meant something in the other consoles, but not here. It's just a respect boost. One that literally bumped me up a couple of levels, but still. Well, actually, it bumped me up one level, unfortunately. And I'm still an outsider. After 4 parts, and you'll see what I've been up to in the Mob Wars a little bit later, I'm still an enforcer. But at least I got a level 2 pistol just in time for this mission, because yeah, I'm gonna need it. I am so gonna need it. So with that said, let's continue the story and go into intensive care, where we have to save Monk and the Don from an assassination from the Tattaglia.
The Don's still in bad shape. Why don't you go over to the hospital in Little Italy and keep an eye on things?
You think there's gonna be trouble?
The police got the building under wraps, but they're not our guys, and I don't trust them.
No, I'm just going to the hospital to see Pop.
No, I want to send some bodyguards with him, all right?
He'll be all right. Solazzo knows he's a civilian.
All right, be careful, huh?
Yes, sir.
Send somebody with him anyway.
Hi.
Hi. Guard duty, huh?
Yeah, you?
I'm here to see Marty. Listen. Thanks. There's nothing I hate more than playing the damsel in distress, but I appreciate what you did. I guess I better go in.
Hey.
Yeah?
I was thinking, maybe we should, you know...
No, we really shouldn't. But we will.
Well, since we didn't have to travel this way, well, at least we managed to make it to the hospital. So, unfortunately, all of our guns is gonna be confiscated.
No weapons inside.
Oh, and as for that shotgun there, we'll be getting that later. Don't leave the hospital without it. Normally, we'd buy that from the black market on the overworld in the PS2, but we can't do that here. No siree. So we're gonna have to find Monk's room. Oh, and by the way, don't get into altercations with the cops. That's just not worth it. So, with that said, we gotta talk to Frankie to continue on the mission. And yeah, I may be talking over people, but the lips aren't moving and it's not really a cutscene. This used to be a cutscene. But now there's an assassin. So we gotta be careful. Cause, oh actually, we don't have a gun. We have the vault over now.
Come out.
And now we're gonna have to break this guy's neck just so we could get the gun from him. So with that said, let's go on ahead and kill him at least. Now I'm gonna take the gun, and now that I have the gun, I'm gonna have to get Frankie out of the hospital as quickly as humanly possible.
I'm sorry.
Who are you?
I'm Michael Corleone. Men are coming here tonight to kill my father.
I'm here to help. Clemenza sent me. What happened to the police? The guards?
I don't know, but I have an idea. I'm gonna get the nurse to move my father to another room. Hey, you better get your girl out of here. There's a way out through the basement. Go find Tom Hagen. Tell him what's going on.
Hey, keep away from the front door. They may be out there already.
It's time for us to get Frankie out of here. This is something that's new because this wasn't literally an escort mission.
Jeez, he must have been looking for the Don.
In fact,
I hope he's okay.
We practically had to talk to Frankie. Frankie ran into Monk, and then you personally had to clear the assassins. But now you've got Frankie escorting you, so you cannot let any harm come to her. She'll get out of harm's way. But first, we're gonna grab this shotgun. And, by the way, that was a shotgun upgrade that was missable, I do believe, in the original PS2 version. No, wait, nope, they weren't. Because all the shotgun upgrades were practically in the compounds. So, let's see. The guys I'm killing, Leo Melano, and the guy that's going to be in this room right here, which is Mario Pagallo, they used to be sport hunters. You know, they hunted ducks and bears and stuff like that. Ironic that a shotgun took him out. And speaking of irony, we got Michael Pazino and Rafael Viviano. Rafael used to be a slugger for the LA Dodgers until he got on a cold streak and was forced to join the Tattaglias. Michael Pazino, by the way, used to be a paperboy until he joined the Tattaglias, and then he died. Nico Abruzzi. The only thing about Nico that is relevant is the fact that he, well, just begged to be on the Tattaglias. And Paolo Gatto, he is the brother of Pauly Gatto, and that also totally not fuck things over. And Robert Ciccio and Ricardo Leone, these guys, they're the guys you don't want to see in a party. Oh, and there's Silvio Amato.
Son of a bitch.
Well, what's his deal? He used to be a chiropractor, and then I killed him. Let's see, we got at least some wine here, so at least you'll be fine. And we've got heat. Lots and lots of heat. There's no need to bring a bat here. At least you got the bat. Just in case you need to go, you know, killing people. Oh, look, there's Tino Capuzzi. They used to call him Tiny because, well, let's just say he's sort of like The Miz. Anyway, we've got one guy in the room. We're going to have to kill him as soon as we... Oh, wait, and there's Tito Costanza. That's the guy we had to kill. And Alberto Santana. Those guys, they're bumbling idiots that the Tattaglias had to basically just do guard duty, and he can't even do that right. So, with that said, we gotta kill the rest of these idiots that are in the area. And they aren't gonna be too far. There's only a limited amount of people left. This isn't really hard. Now, see, last time, we actually had to pick up the garrote line and actually kill... No, that's the wrong mission. That's somebody else. But last time, we had to get our stuff from the guard, because the guard would have already been killed. But, this time we didn't. Also, let's see. I'm going the wrong way. You fool, turn around. The door is back that way. Thank you. And there's a few more assassins left to kill. Oh, there they are. And one of them is Angelo Pizzano. They called him the Pissant for short. Because, well, that's what he was. And the other guy wasn't important, because I just killed him. So, with that said, we can just talk to Michael, because we cleared all the assassins.
We've got to cover the front entrance.
So, with that said, the mission's complete.
Not a fucking muscle.
I thought I got all you guinea hoods locked up. What the hell are you doing here?
What's the Turk paying you to set up my father, Captain?
Take a hold of him. Stand him up. Stand him up straight.
Told you not to get involved, didn't I?
I'm attorney for the Corleone family. These men are private detectives hired to protect Vito Corleone. If you interfere, you'll have to appear before a judge in the morning to show cause.
And with that, intensive care has been completed. So, we at least got some respect, but we're not out of the outsiders rank just yet. So, for the most part, at least we got a upgrade for the pistol, but at least we also got a shotgun too. We don't have enough money. Otherwise, I would get myself a bunch of long barrel shotgun clips. But since we're done with the story, let's move over to Mob Wars to see how I managed to get up to level 16 in the first place. First things first, I went there and pretty much took over the last territory in Brooklyn. Let me rephrase that, Little Italy, because that's where the Corleones were located. So I managed to take over 4 territories the last time you saw me, and I pretty much gotten a racket with weakness bonus. So yeah, we're pretty much in good standing. So all we got to do is get back to our car. Let's see if there's anything else here. Nope, there isn't. So let's get back to the car and bask in the glory that we pretty much run Little Italy for right now. The only thing that's left now is for us to deal with the Tattaglias, and the Tattaglias have been trying to take our land for God knows how long. They are starting to become an absolute pain in the ass. And speaking to people that are being pains in the asses, the Cuneo family are pains in the asses because they took one of our cards. And so too is the Strassi because they took our goddamn money. Oh look, the Tattaglias went there and took the Lower East Side again. These guys are really starting to piss me off, but don't worry, they won't piss me off for long, but at least I got some skill up points, yay. So that means I could level up shooting and level up health. Might as well. Yeah, let's level up health. We need the health recovery at least. So on that note, let's get some money, and we're gonna go on ahead and try to get that land back. Not try, we will get that land back. Because you see, the fact that he basically took our land That was the worst mistake he could have ever possibly done. So, on that note, let's see what all we can do here. We can get a large kickback, which would lower the vendetta, but lower the defense. Let's see. Diamond and gold ripoff. Let's rip off some people. Let's first rip off the Tattaglias, because fuck them. Let's see. Hijack car. Don't need to move anybody here. Tip off. Ooh. So we can raise the Heat family up to Tattaglias. So that way, they'll have the cops on them. And we will take... I could take from any one of them, so I'm just going ahead and steal from the Tattaglias. Might as well. Ooh, we can't capo promotion anyone just yet. None of them are a rank of soldier. Shit. Not now. Not right now. We're going to go on ahead and move our... We can't move any more mobsters. Because we already moved one, so we're going to have to play a mission to take back our land that was taken from us. Because, you see, these guys have no right to come into my business and take my shit without my permission. And you know what? It's time to start killing them. Columbo Bendelli. That guy was known as Bendover Bendelli because for some reason they tricked people into bending him over so they could kick him in the ass. Alright, next up, we got... Oh, those guys again. We already talked about those guys. Oh, Raphael Baccio and Paulie Calvano. They were pretty much in the last episode, so we killed them. Dino Gambio. Seen him too. Already killed that fucker. And Elmo Ferrari. Killed him too. See, the Time Lord tends to bring back people that tends to, you know, die. That's kind of the curse of having to bring back made men you killed and have them work for you. You unfortunately have to bring back all people. Thus is the curse of being the Time Lord. Oh, we've probably got some more stragglers around here somewhere. They'll probably get wary of me about now. Oh, there they are. Give them a little bit more time. They'll show up. Come on. I know you're there. Oh, there you are. There's Enrico Maserati. Killed him too with a disarmed execution, no less. And Enzo Zoff. Killed him too. Ernesto Benito. Killed him too. See, the Time Lord brings back people. It's not like Aldo can control his Time Lord powers or anything. He just tends to do that. And at least I thought I found a bottle, but apparently I didn't. That's a shame. And this, by the way, was our hideout to try to... Oh, God! I didn't even see that guy coming. Oh, and that was Federico Senni. Killed him, too! So, yeah, let's see if there's any... bottles of wine to heal myself. Well, nope. It's time for us to get out of here. Because, well, we managed to kill off all the Tattaglias that took this territory from me. After I worked so hard to Shylock the woman that ran the business out of the money. So, yeah. Let's hop back in the car. And this retaliation is done. And guess what? Somebody got promoted. Oh wait, nobody didn't get promoted. Damn, I thought they did. Oh well, we're gonna move on to the next phase since the intimidation is over. And now they've strengthened their family and took money from us, you assholes. We're gonna have to deal with the Cuneos next. Oh shit, they're starting to move in on Barzini. And they've strengthened their racket. Oh, you fuckers. Of course you come back after the... You know what? I'm getting sick and tired of having to take that territory from them. I really am. But at least I got some skill points. But it's time to get revenge on the Tattaglia, because guess what? The one land that they didn't have guarded was the one near their safe house. Unfortunately, their safe house was absolutely dirt weak, and I might as well show this off since I'm at the area anyway and I managed to kill a couple of people here and snuck in. So it's basically the same way as the Godfather, the game for the other systems, where you kill off all the gangsters that are there and blow up the compounds. Thing is, they can't blow up your I think they can blow up your compound. No, wait, you can't. They cannot blow up your compound. They can attack you, but they cannot blow up your compound for some reason. You can blow them up, and you can kill off all their gangsters, but you cannot blow up their compound. And by the way, this is how I managed to get the level 16. Because I managed to not only take the land, well, I managed to not only kill a bunch of goons, but I'm going to go on ahead and take this whole entire territory. I'm going to have to go up front, aren't I? Well, time for me to say hello. I did murder a good number of people on the way here, too. They're all people I've already killed, by the way, in case you're wondering. That's why I didn't show it at all. And here they are. Marto Tizzato killed him too. Anyone else I need to kill? Nope, I haven't killed him. Niccolo DiMartini. He used to be a bartender, but then he was forced into the Tattaglias by Solazzo. Oh god, that hurt. And that hurt him even more. Let's grab my Tommy gun and prepare to start going off on these guys. I know there's more of them in the basement. There is more in the basement. Let's see. Anyone else? Nope. I think we cleared the compound except for what's in the basement. So let's say hello. Because there's a capo regime in the basement. I forgot to mention that. There are capos in the basement. Oh, actually, no. There's soldiers in the basement. So, with that said, before they can make anybody capos, I'm killing them. And Berto Alioto, I've killed him too. So yeah, that's pretty much everybody. So, let's go on ahead and make sure we open the door so we have a clear cut a path to get out of here. Because this game runs really slow, but the meter runs fast. And once we get out of here, we are done with the compound. However, the heat is definitely going to be on us, since we managed to take all of the Tattaglia's lands. And guess what? In order for Strassi, Barzini, and Cuneo to come after the Tattaglia's lands, they're going to have to get through Little Italy first. And I'm going to destroy Barzini. No, Cuneo. I'm going to destroy Cuneo first before anything else. So, with that said, the Tattaglias have been finished. They are done. They are dead. It is over. And we got a new weapon upgrade, and a mobster's been promoted. Armando Alioto is now a capo. I'm gonna have to add some new neutral territory to that. Oh, I'm gonna definitely have to add some new territory to that. So, with that said, I can't move any mobsters. Damn! I've already moved them, so... They've stole money from the Cuneos. Took cards from us. Raised the heat. Killed! Oh, you gotta be kidding me! Well, I'm gonna have to get that land back. But we've got ourselves some skills points, at least, from... Oh, we only got one. We only got one. Okay. At least we got some more health. And we got magnum bullets this time. Ooh, and a double barrel shotgun upgrade. We're gonna have to get some more money for that. So, with that said, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're gonna end this here and in the next episode of The Godfather, The Mob Wars. We're going to have to continue the story as we got to retaliate on the people responsible for trying to kill the Don. This is RVMan985. Peace out and take care.